Hello, comic book fans. I just got this today and I'm absolutely thrilled to talk about it. It's Monsters, the Marvel Monster Bus by Stan Lee, Larry Leiber, and Jack Kirby. And this is volume one. Now, this collects a lot of old comic books from way back in the day. All about featuring giant monsters, which I absolutely love. I haven't read all of these before in my youth. I remember when I was a kid and first going to comic book stores, I'd always hit up the bargain bins and you'd find some of these old comic books in the bargain bins. And I read a lot of these kind of things, and especially like the Marvel horror comics, like Werewolf by Night and Frankenstein and stuff like that. And I do remember reading some of this stuff. I haven't read it all, so I'm super excited to kind of read a bunch of all these things. So in volume one, you get Strange Tales of the Unusual number 7, Astonishing number 56, World of Fantasy number 15 to 19, Strange Worlds number 1, number 3 to 5, Tales of Astonish number 1, and number 3 to 21. Strange Tales number 67 to 70, and number 72 to 86. Tales of Suspense number 2 to 19. Journey into Mystery number 51 to 70, and Amazing Adventures number 1 and 2. Kind of cool. They got that cool image on the inside. I like when they do stuff like that, like the X-Men Age of Apocalypse on this. This was before Marvel was producing superheroes, so of course you got Groot. He started out as a giant monster attacking a city. This guy was actually called the Hulk. You'll see him later in this book. Again, like all the other Marvel omnibuses, this is a really good quality book. Lots of little extras in it. And this is like, of course, very old school style comics. You got a lot of exposition, a lot of dialogue, and the old style artwork. And a lot of these are short stories because they were parts of collections like World of Fantasy, which would kind of like what Spider-Man started out in the Amazing Fantasy. So you get a bunch of little, like these are just mostly a bunch of little short stories, which may not appeal to everyone, but I certainly liked it. These are just fun to read. It's definitely a product of its time, where people were at. Like back in the 40s and 50s, people were really into like all this weird sci-fi and giant monsters and irradiated creatures. And they do have a lot of those kind of like classic, like little silly designs. They just got these just out of world creatures in this book. Giant metal guy called Colossus. I haven't done too much research. It would be interesting if a lot of these old monsters and like named after current superheroes actually, if the superheroes were actually kind of drawn off of these old stories, or if they just the names of them were a coincidence. I mean, Groot is very similar in this. He's, I mean, but in this, he's just a He's a giant talking tree that smashes shit. Instead of what he is in Guardians of the Galaxy. This old sci-fi stuff. Kind of curious how popular this book will be considering what it is. I don't know if there's a lot of taste for this kind of stuff out there, especially like a lot of short story formats. As you can see, like, this story is like literally only a few pages long, which is like pretty much every story in this book. Yeah, there you go. What is you, or at least the original incarnation of Hulk, or I don't even know if the gamma irradiated Hulk we all love today is spawned off of this, or if it's just a coincidence, like I said earlier. It's just kind of interesting. Just gives you a cool idea of what Marvel Comics was really all about back in the day before they were big into superheroes. They were really into like the sci-fi fantasy. This looks very similar to that beast that appeared in the Marvel Godzilla comics. I don't know if any of you have ever remember reading those. I think there was a 24-issue story arc. He fought like a giant Yeti in the third or fourth issue. It's so awesome. I love all the old cover designs too. They always have like a little bit of dialogue to give you an idea of what's going on in the story, and these big bold letters, colors, to really try and make things stand out. Some of this, the extras in the back here. sketch work before the colors. This stuff's kind of definitely neat. Kind of definitely fits with the 50s vibe. It just kind of reminds me of the old monster black and white movies. And then you get a... cover gallery. And that is the Marvel Monster Bus Volume 1. I can't wait to dig into this stuff. This stuff's right up my alley. I love this kind of stuff. Volume 2 is coming out later this year. Obviously, this kind of stuff isn't for everyone. If these kind of like old comic books and is something you're into, and these old like fantasy sci-fi, and this one's all. Course focused on giant monsters, if that's something you're interested in, yeah, you should definitely pick this up. Of course, it's a Marvel omnibus, so it's really good quality. So yeah, that's the Monsters Monster Bus. Thanks for watching my video, everyone.